Hi there, my name is Randy Dary, and we are on the north side of my shop here. Some of the more picturesque wood around this place. This is what I'll be looking out at as I sing to you, and hopefully you sing with me. This is field north of my house. You might hear planes going over or cars going by. There's a road out there. But anyway, this is what I have to look at instead of your smiling faces. It's July in 2020, and I'm doing this instead of coming to wherever you are. So I wanted to tell you a few things about this before I get started. First of all, these different songs were recorded in different places. And so the background, the sound of where I am might sound different on different songs. Next thing is I put the words on here. I figured this is for the summer reading program in Lake County Library. Summer reading program, so I thought it'd be good to have words for you to read. Every once in a while, I'd say maybe in three songs or something in this group, there's a word that I might say a different word than what's on the words you're looking at. So forgive me for that, but it was too hard to change it, so I didn't. The other thing is that these songs are, this reading program is fairy tales, and the closest I could come with some of these songs are like fairy tales because they have animals that talk and kind of magical things happen, things that really couldn't happen in real life. So I hope that you'll think it fits in some to the fairy tale thing. The first song we're going to do is called Sneaky Snake. And I don't like snakes all that much, but this snake might not be too bad a one to know. So here's Sneaky Snake. Boys and girls, take warning, if you go near the lake, keep your eyes wide open and look for a sneaky snake. Now maybe you won't see him, and maybe you won't hear, but he'll sneak up behind you and drink all of your root beer. And then Sneaky Snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky Snake goes dancing, giggling and a kissing. I don't like old Sneaky Snake, he laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath. Well, Sneaky Snake drinks root beer, and he just makes me sick. When he is not dancing, he looks just like a stick. Now, he doesn't have any arms or legs. You cannot see his ears. And while we are not looking, he's stealing our root beers. And then Sneaky Snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky Snake goes dancing, giggling and a kissing. I don't like old Sneaky Snake,
He laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath. And then Sneaky Snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky Snake goes dancing, giggling and a kissing. I don't like old Sneaky Snake. He laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath.
All right. I'll say, good job. I don't really know if you did a good job or not, but I hope you did. The next song is about some animals out in a barn dancing, and it's called Barn Dance. It's by a man named Tom T. Hall. Hope you like this one.
One night as I lay sleeping, something awakened me. There was a light on in my barn, so I went down to see. I peeked through a big old crack in the door, and what do you think I saw? The animals were having a barn dance right in the horse's stall. And there was a chicken doing the chicken reel, and the muskrat rambled on. The old cow did the cow-cow boogie, and the rooster crowed a song. The mouse came out of his hiding place, and he danced on one leg. The old hen got so tickled that she almost laid an egg. They were all dressed up for the barn dance. It made me want to laugh. The rabbit wore a big bow tie, and the pig was a-looking in the looking glass. The goose danced with the gander till an old goat butted in. The horse was a-horsing around a lot till the mare got mad at him. And there was a chicken doing the chicken reel, and the muskrat rambled on. The old cow did the cow-cow boogie, and the rooster crowed a song. The mouse came out of his hiding place, and he danced on one leg. The old hen got so tickled that she almost laid an egg. And there was a chicken doing the chicken reel, and the muskrat rambled on. The old cow did the cow-cow boogie, and the rooster crowed a song. The mouse came out of his hiding place, and he danced on one leg. The old hen got so tickled that she almost laid an egg.
Next we have a song about an animal who's, I think, considered pretty smart, pretty tricky, a fox. And I know there's a cartoon character in the old Roadrunner cartoons. His enemy is Wile-E Coyote. Well, you know, Wile-E is a word, W-I-L-Y, and it means tricky, I think. And that's what you might call a fox. So this fox is kind of tricky, as we'll sing.
The fox went out on a chilly night. He prayed for the moon for to give him light, for he'd many a mile to go that night afore he reached the town, oh, town, oh, town, oh, many a mile to go that night afore he reached the town, oh. He ran till he came to a great big bin where the ducks and the geese were kept therein. He said, a couple of you are gonna grease my chin afore I leave this town, oh, town, oh, town, oh, a couple of you are gonna grease my chin afore I leave this town, oh. He grabbed the gray goose by the neck, threw the duck across his back. He didn't mind its quack, 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 and its legs all dangling down, oh, down, oh, down, oh. He didn't mind quack, 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 and the legs all dangling down, oh. Then old Mother Flipper Flapper jumped out of bed. Out of the window she cocked her head, crying, John, John, the gray goose is gone, and the fox is on the town, oh, town, oh, town, oh, John, John, the gray goose is gone, and the fox is on the town, oh. Then John, he ran to the top of the hill, blew his horn both loud and shrill. The fox, he said, I better flee with my kill, or they'll soon be on my trail, oh, trail, oh, trail, oh. The fox, he said, I better flee with my kill, or they'll soon be on my trail, oh. He ran till he came to a cozy den. There were the little ones, 8, 9, 10. Daddy, Daddy, better go back again, for it must be a mighty fine town, oh, town, oh, town, oh. They said, Daddy, Daddy, better go back again, for it must be a mighty fine town, oh. Then the fox and his wife, without any strife, cut up the goose with a fork and knife. They never had such a supper in their life. And the little ones chewed on the bones, oh, bones, oh, bones, oh. They never had such a supper in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones, oh.
I hate to tell you this, but we're going to sing a sad song. I mean, it's sad for a while, but I'll tell you, it does have a happy ending. So don't worry about it. Just go along with it for now. This song comes from Mexico. At least the tune does. Maybe the story does too. And it's about Mr. Cat. But in Spanish, he is Don Gato. So here is the story of Don Gato.
Señor Don Gato was a cat on a high red roof. Don Gato sat. He went there to read a letter, meow, 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 where the reading light was better, meow, meow, meow. 'Twas a love note for Don Gato. I adore you, wrote the lady cat, who was fluffy, white, and nice and fat. There was not a sweeter kitty, meow, 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 in the country or the city, meow, meow, meow. And she said she'd wed Don Gato. Oh, Don Gato jumped so happily. He fell off the roof and broke his knee, broke his ribs and all his whiskers, meow, 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 and his little solar plexus, meow, meow, meow. Ay, caramba, cried Don Gato. Then the doctors all came on the run, just to see if something could be done. And they held a consultation, meow, 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 about how to save their patient, meow, 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 how to save Señor Don Gato. But in spite of everything they tried, poor Señor Don Gato up and died. Oh, it wasn't very merry, meow, 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 going to the cemetery, meow, 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 for the ending of Don Gato. When the funeral passed in the market square, Such a smell of fish was in the air. Though his burial was slated, meow, 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 he became reanimated, meow, meow, meow. He came back to life, Don Gato.
Okay, well, how about another cat song? Now, this one I prepared more for younger kids. This one has pictures. So it's called I Had a Cat. And it the first verse ends up with, cat goes fiddle-i-fee. So then the next animal is a hen. And the hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. And then there's a picture of a cat. And so you're supposed to say, cat goes fiddle-i-fee. And as the song goes on, you add an animal. And then you go back and do the sound that all the other animals did. There's a fancy word for this kind of a song. It's called a cumulative song. It accumulates. It gets bigger as it goes. So here we go with I Had a Cat. I had a cat and the cat pleased me. I fed my cat under yonder tree. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a hen and the hen pleased me. I fed my hen under yonder tree. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a duck and the duck pleased me. I fed my duck under yonder tree. Duck goes quack, quack. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a goose and the goose pleased me. I fed my goose under yonder tree. Goose goes hissy, hissy. Duck goes quack, quack. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a sheep and the sheep pleased me. I fed my sheep under yonder tree. Sheep goes baa, baa. Goose goes hissy, hissy. Duck goes quack, quack. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a cow and the cow pleased me. I fed my cow under yonder tree. Cow goes moo, moo. Sheep goes baa, baa. Goose goes hissy, hissy. Duck goes quack, quack. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. I had a horse and the horse pleased me. I fed my horse under yonder tree. Horse goes neigh, neigh. Cow goes moo, moo. Sheep goes baa, baa. Goose goes hissy, hissy. Duck goes quack, quack. Hen goes chimmy-chuck, chimmy-chuck. Cat goes fiddle-i-fee. On this next song, I'm going to switch instruments. And play the ukulele, or ukulele as we seem to call it on the mainland. But in Hawaii they call it an ukulele. And I used a little instrument because this is kind of a little song. It's called Apples and Bananas, and it's real simple. It just says, I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. But then you go back and you use the different vowels, you know, A, E, I, O, U. We're not going to use Y. They say sometimes Y, but we're not going to use Y. So then we sing, I like to eat, eat, eat. use all A sounds, and then we'll use all E sounds, and then we'll use all I sounds, then all O sounds, then all U sounds. Okay? Apples and bananas.
I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to eat, eat, eat apples and bananas. I like to oat, oat, oat apples and bananas. I like to oat, oat, oat apples and bananas. I like to oot, oot, oot apples and bananas. I like to oot, oot, oot apples and bananas.
Okay, the next song is actually three songs, so it's a medley. Now, medley is a word that means more than one song tied together. A song, a tune, is a melody, but when you put more than one song together, more than one melody together, you get medley. So this is called, I call it the 1890s medley, because these songs are all over 100 years old, way over actually. One of them goes back into the 1890s. I think the other two were a little later. So you won't know the first two maybe. The first one's called In the Good Old Summertime, which is, it's summertime. The second one is, it's either called Bicycle Built for Two or Daisy. And the third one, you might know, it's called Take Me Out to the Ball Game. I don't know if we're going to have ball games this summer, but we can hope. So here we go with the 1890s medley.
In the good old summertime, in the good old summertime, strolling through a shady lane with your baby mine. You hold her hand and she holds yours, and that's a very good sign that she's your tootsie wootsie in the good old summertime. Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage, I can't afford a carriage, but you'd look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two. Take me out to the ball game, take me out with the crowd, buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack, I don't care if I ever get back. Let me root, root, root for the home team, if they don't win it's a shame, for it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
All right, good. Now, in this next one, I don't know if you're old enough for this next one, but this next one's kind of a love song. But it's kind of a peppy, happy love song. It's about a girl. This guy's girlfriend is named Cindy. And so if there's any of you out there named Cindy, I hope you won't be embarrassed by this song or mad at me for this song. I hope you'll take it as a tribute to you, Cindy. Okay, here we go.
I wish I was an apple, a hanging on the tree, and every time my sweetheart passed, she'd take a bite of me. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home, Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime. You ought to see my Cindy, she lives away down south. She's so sweet, the honeybees swarm around her mouth. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home, Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime. The first time that I saw her, she was standing at the door, her shoes and stockings in her hand and her feet all over the floor. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime. Cindy is my darling, so sweet I wanna cry. And if she would not love me, I fear that I would die. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime. She told me that she loved me, she called me Sugar Plum. She throwed her arms around me, I thought my time had come. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime. Get along home, Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, get along home. Cindy, Cindy, I'll marry you sometime.
All right, next we have another sad song, I'm afraid. And this song doesn't actually have a happy ending, although there is one kind of funny thing right at the end. I hope you think it's funny anyway. This is about a guy and his wife, and something bad happens to him, and then something bad happens to her. So that's kind of a sad story, right? But it's what happened on Springfield Mountain.
On Springfield Mountain there did dwell a handsome youth, I knew him well. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. One Monday morning he did go down in the meadow for to mow. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. When he had mowed but half the field, a pesky serpent bit his heel. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. He took his scythe and with a blow he laid the pesky serpent low. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. He took the sarpent in his hand and straightway went to Molly Bland. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. Oh, Molly, Molly, here you see the pesky sarpent what bit me. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. Now Molly had a ruby lip with which the poison she did sip. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo. But Molly had a rotten tooth, and so the poison killed them both. Tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo, tooloo-ree-ay, tooloo-ree-oo.
Okay, well, after that sad song, we'll bring a little joy to the world. This is a song by a man named Hoyt Axton, and your parents or your grandparents, maybe great-grandparents. This song was popular, I think, in the early 1970s, so a good long time ago, 50 years ago. Of course, the nice thing about music is if it was recorded, we can hear it and enjoy it even 50 years later or 100 years later. So this is called Joy to the World.
Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine. I never understood a single word he said, but we always had a mighty fine time. Yes, we always had a mighty fine time, singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. If I were the king of the world, tell you what I'd do. I'd throw away the tears and the fears and the jeers and have a good time with you. Yes, I'd have a good time with you, singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. Joy to the world, all the boys and girls. Joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. Singing joy to you and me, singing joy to you and me.
All right, next is a song about the old days. I don't know when, old days. I kind of remember stuff like in this song when I was a kid. So that was quite a few years ago. The song, I think, was made famous by a singer named John Denver. But it's about Grandma's feather bed, going out to Grandma's house and having good food, and the relatives are all there and they're sitting around chatting, and you go to bed in this great big feather bed and have sweet dreams. So, Grandma's feather bed.
Now when I was a little bitty boy, just up off of the floor, we used to go out to Grandma's house every month and or so. We'd have chicken pie and country ham and homemade butter on the bread. But the best darn thing about Grandma's house was a great big feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide and soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4011 geese. Took a whole bolt of cloth for the tick. It'd hold 8 kids and 4 hound dogs and the piggy we took from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. And after supper, we'd sit around the fire and the old folks would spit and chew. And my pa would talk about the farm and the war, and my granny'd sing a ballad or two. And I'd sit and listen and watch the fire till the cobwebs filled my head. The next thing I know, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the old feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide and soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4011 geese. Took a whole bolt of cloth for the tick. It'd hold 8 kids and 4 hound dogs and the piggy we took from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. I love my ma, I love my pa, I love Granny and Grandpa too. I've been fishing with my uncle, I wrestled with my cousin, I even kissed Aunt Lou, whoo! But if I ever had to make a choice, I guess it ought to be said that I'd trade them all plus the gal down the road for Grandma's feather bed. It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide and soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 4011 geese. Took a whole bolt of cloth for the tick. It'd hold 8 kids and 4 hound dogs and the piggy we took from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
Now, the next song, I usually like to sing this next song most in the winter time when it's cold. It's not a winter song. It's about a nice warm place, an island maybe, a nice sandy beach, and there's a lazy coconut tree. That's what this song is called, Lazy Coconut Tree.
Some folk like to go fishing far across the bay. I would rather be dreaming on the beach all day. Like the lazy coconut, coconut tree. Like the lazy coconut, coconut tree. I could be a rich merchant in some fine bazaar, but I'd rather be happy nodding to a star. Like the lazy coconut, coconut tree. Like the lazy coconut, coconut tree. La 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 la. La 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 la. Like the lazy coconut, coconut tree. 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 Coconut tree. Coconut tree.
Here's another song that's Well, it's kind of a reminiscing song also. Reminisce, that means to think back to when you were younger. Now, if you're only five or so, you don't have to think very far. But for someone like me, that's quite a ways ago, quite a long time ago. And this song, it kind of might seem like it was a kid's song, but it's really being sung by a grown-up, a person who's thinking back to when they were a kid, in this case a boy. You could, now it starts out by saying, when I was just a wee little lad, which is a boy, but if you're a girl, you could sing lass, okay? L-A-S-S. So when I was just a wee little lass, I think there might be another word in there somewhere that you'd have to change. But anyway, you can do that on The Marvelous Toy.
When I was just a wee little lad, full of health and joy, my father homeward came one night. He gave to me a toy, a wonder to behold it was, with many colors bright. And the moment I laid eyes on it, it became my heart's delight. It went zip when it moved, and bop when it stopped, whirr when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. The first time that I picked it up, I had a big surprise, 'cause right on the bottom were two big buttons that looked like big green eyes. I first pushed one and then the other, then I twisted its lid, and when I set it down again, here is what it did. It went zip when it moved, and bop when it stopped, whirr when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. It first marched left and then marched right, then marched under a chair. And when I looked where it had gone, it wasn't even there. I started to cry, but my dad, he laughed, 'cause he knew that I would find, when I turned around, my marvelous toy chugging right behind. It went zip when it moved, and bop when it stopped, whirr when it stood still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will. Well, the years have gone by too quickly, it seems, and I have my own little boy. And yesterday I gave to him my marvelous little toy. His eyes nearly popped right out of his head, and he gave a squeal of glee. Neither one of us knows just what it is, but he loves it just like me. It still goes zip when it moves, and pop when it stops, whirr when it stands still. I never knew just what it was, and I guess I never will.
This next song kind of has something to do with why I like music, why I do music. I have to admit, I didn't start out in life to become a music teacher or even a music performer. I just liked music. I liked playing instruments. It was fun to operate the machine that is an instrument. And so I like this song very much, and I hope you will too. When it first came out and got kind of famous, a company that makes soft drinks used it as a theme song, and so it kind of became famous on in commercials for "I'd like to buy the world a Coke" is what it was. So it's called "I'd like to teach the world to sing."
I'd like to build the world a home and furnish it with love. Grow apple trees and honeybees and snow-white turtle doves. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to hold it in my arms and keep it company. I'd like to see the world for once all standing hand in hand and hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land. That's the song I hear. Let the world sing today. A song of peace that echoes on and never goes away. Put your hand in my hand, let's begin today. Put your hand in my hand, help me find the way. I'd like to teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to hold it in my arms and keep it company. I'd like to see the world for once all standing hand in hand and hear them echo through the hills for peace throughout the land.
All right, last but not least, a special song, I think, and it'll sound quite different. I recorded this song in a more of a studio setting. I have a recorder that can record different tracks, and so you can record like your guitar playing, and then you can go back and listen to that and sing along with it. And then you can go back and play another guitar part, or sometimes on this one I added a bass. I added myself singing again a couple of different, you'll hear me doing some harmony with myself. And so this one is called The Garden Song.
Make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds and picking stones, we are made of dreams and bones. I feel the need to grow my own, 'cause the time is close at hand. Grain for grain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music from the land. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. So plant your rows straight and long, and temper them with prayer and song. Mother Earth will keep you strong if you give her love and care. Old Crow watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden, I'm as free as that
feathered thief up there. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down.
That's about it, I think. I'd like to go out with one in-person song here. Get my guitar on. This is a song, this is just part of a song by a man named Woody Guthrie. My guitar has been out here in the sun. Man named Woody Guthrie. Woody Guthrie wrote a song called This Land Is Your Land, This Land Is My Land. He wrote lots of other songs too. This particular song he wrote during what they call the Dust Bowl. It happened back in the 1930s, I think. Terrible time for folks down in a certain part of the country, but this song, this part of the song is probably good for our closing here. It says, so long, it's been good to know ya. So long, it's been good to know ya. So long, it's been good to know ya. What a long time since I've been home. And I've gotta be drifting. So, have a good summer, stay safe, and I'll hope to sing with you again sometime.